Hello, everyone. This is Nick at Emwig, and we are going to continue with our little series here of Medieval 2 Total War. Now, we just took Antioch and Baghdad last turn, or last episode, better said, so we're going to have to see what we can do to keep solidifying our hold. At the bare minimum, try to get Turkey as quickly as possible, but we're going to have to probably wage war on the Egyptians before then, because, yeah, they're right here on our doorstep. So we're gonna have to see what we need to do to get ready for that. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I've done not everything I can do. Do we want to wait for, let's see, another Saracen? Yeah, you know what, we're gonna wait two more turns just sitting here in Antioch so we can get hopefully one more chivalry for the crown prince. And one more unit of Saracen militia, probably another unit of spears after these guys come in. So we're going to kind of load up on infantry and start swinging south and just taking out the Egyptians there. Now in Mosul, Mosul is going to be our primary recruiting facility here. Oh, they can already, oh, that's nice. They can already build spear militia here, so they're already upkeeped. Yeah, look at that. There you go. That's beautiful. So we'll retrain you. We'll keep you. Yeah, we'll retrain them, actually. Why not? Get them back up to full strength. Send you guys back to... Actually, you know what? We'll take the Turkomans and disband them. We'll take the Sipahis and retrain them in Mosul. Get them back up to 80. And we'll start... Yeah, we'll leave the Afghan... Oh, this is so difficult sometimes, deciding who to take, when to take them, what to do. We'll take all of this, actually... We'll leave them here, we'll get those guys going into there to train up. Yeah, we'll get you a grain exchange. And I do believe, actually, they can train spear militia, so there's no reason to keep this guy here. Let's actually take these two troops and swing them south to assist with the Egyptian campaign. And I think that is where we will leave off this turn. Actually, do we need any agents moving around? No, it doesn't look like it. No, they've all moved. Oh yeah, we lost a spy last turn, didn't we? A suitable husband, 44 years of age, speaks of loyalty. No thank you, Gunduz. I appreciate the offer, but I don't want you in my family. Small masjid in Baghdad, that means someone got some rule. Yes, he did. Salih al-Ali got the second point in rule, which is great. Too bad he has winning first. Oh, and he's poor with taxes and fiscally challenged. Did he just pick this up, like, right now? Literally right this turn, he picked up these two horrible traits. What a champ. I think, at least. I haven't checked to see if, Oh, yeah, that's a welcome... Yeah. We'll get the Iconium. Yeah, we need our border towns upgrading nice and quickly. But I said, I was going to recruit these guys, and I'm going to recruit those guys. That's exactly what I'm going to do. How many did that? 62. Well, we can leave them behind when we go take all of that. Yeah, we'll retrain them, get them back up to speed. We will hire two more spear militia here so this place can have a garrison when we take all of this out to go swing west, take Edessa and Aleppo. So yeah, they'll get a little bit of a garrison. You know what? They're going to be pretty uncontested. We'll just leave them with one spear militia. So they're happy, have a garrison. Nobody can take them over instantly, but at the same time, you know, it's not necessary to put anything in there. They're completely unthreatened. Tbilisi, we'll leave that for now. I definitely want to solidify a little bit more of a hold down here before I start putting my finances into supporting a war up here into Trebizond. Because I'm going to be spreading myself very, very, very thin if I start building up another army here. Especially since I... Oh, we're about to get a castle, but that doesn't give me anything. No, we need a fortress to get the dismounted Sipahis. Conium could probably use one more spear militia. Just on the off chance, if they get a big army coming down here, I'm going to need to recruit as many as possible in the quickest amount possible. And since this only has two recruitment slots, I believe we get a third with this. Oh no, only two still with the stone wall. I think a large stone wall allows you to get three recruitment slots. You know what? I can check. Yes, the large stone wall, you can recruit three at a time. But I want to kind of start inching towards getting, you know, six or seven spearmen in here, just on the off chance that we get a big Byzantine army coming down. And I believe with the recruitment of these two, we should start marching south. It'd be probably a good idea to take Aleppo, but no, not yet, not yet. Let's just start layering. Ooh, I'm actually surprised. Huh. The Catholic factions have not waged a crusade. Oh, they do that around turn 20, don't they? Yeah, the Catholics probably around 20, 21 will crusade Cairo. So we're going to get a lot of Europeans coming down here at some point in time. And it would probably be beneficial to start weakening Egypt a little bit for them, or wait, or should I wait for them to crusade before I start laying into them? Decisions. Do I take Aleppo first? I'll think about that as I keep playing and end this turn. Okay, I think that's pretty much all I can do. Let's end the turn. Nobody. Nothing. Nothing of importance happening around here. Okay, let's decide what to do after we look through all this. Procrastination is the name of the game. Oh, we didn't reinforce that place. Oh, what a pity. Ooh, chivalrous and rule. Sultan Jalal. Nice. You just got that from standing in here. Huh. Interesting. I guess they can get a point for doing... I don't know. Increasing recruitment or something? Yeah, town militia, you're just going to be a detriment. I don't want to pay upkeep for you guys. Interesting. I'd never paid attention to them getting... rule points for just sitting in a town. It's usually off religious buildings. Okay. What can we build here? Here we can build a land clearance because we want to get you growing nice and quick. Yeah, that's a good idea. And let's go ahead and retrain that unit and move out with... You know what? 22 Turkomans. Yeah, that's just a waste of upkeep, to be honest. 36 Turkish archers. Well, that is 36 Turkish archers. I mean, what can I say? Something is something. Alright, what do we leave behind? We leave you behind because we're retraining you. We will leave... Archers. Yeah, we'll leave... we'll just leave that spear militia behind. Ooh, but you know what? Yeah, let's take Aleppo. I think that would be the right thing to do. So let's get right. Where could these guys go? Yeah, those guys could go to that edge. Okay, good. We'll leave those were there. Okay, everyone in, and we're still in green. Beautiful, 120% happiness. Gotta love that low tax rate. Gotta love it. Alright, here we need... this is just a Mountain Bailey. Alright, how many rams can we build? Three rams. Okay. Three rams. Next turn, that should be ours. And you are safely moving back to Mosul. Oh, you can't retrain because you don't have the facilities to retrain Turkish archers. Peasants. Ugh. Well, what to do then? What to do... you know what? Let's just get him moving over in that direction. We'll leave the Turkish archers. No, we'll take the Turkish archers. Go over there. Ah, and we can get more Afghans. That's nice. That's pretty cool. And we'll get another unit of Sipahis there just to kind of hold the fort down. Yes. That's looking good. All right. Two turns for that, so we'll get another spear militia in there, but as soon as that's up, we're gonna get a town guard. Is it guard? No. City Watch. Okay, so yeah, City Watch, get the Saracen militia going here in Iconium. But let's actually get a. Oh, we can't train a spy. We don't have a shisha bar. Oh, do we have a shisha bar anywhere? I don't think we do. Nope. No, we do not. We cannot train spies. Interesting. Baghdad could use some roads, though. All right. Yeah, that works. That works. And I think that's all I can do for this turn. These are going by nice and quick, so end. And we'll wait to take Aleppo. Ooh, the Egyptians building roads an acre. Candidate for adoption. No. He'd have to be younger with more chivalry and probably like a morale trait. No. I don't think so. Ooh, Adana has upgraded to a castle. That means we can get the masjid. Most advanced are the Byzantines. We're slowly edging on up. We're second in production, only by a 1% loss to the Byzantines, and third in population to a 10% loss over the under the Byzantines, better said. So yeah, we're gonna have to kill them for sure. But I think we can go ahead and plonk a watchtower down right here. And ooh, we're gonna have to leave them under siege for a little bit. Kind of weaken them down. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. We might have to leave them under siege for a while. But we're gonna have to do it. Probably even send over. What do you get into? You get into blue. And our Sultan only has two authority or three? He's got three. That's not bad. We probably won't lose this unit of Sipahis just yet. And we'll leave that in the blue. Blue's not bad. Whoops. Yeah, don't spend any money there. Let's get you growing as quickly as possible. Baghdad's going to be an important one. And that's pretty much all we can do except for this battle. Am I correct? Yes, I believe I am. All right, let's go for it. Let's go for it, Crown Prince. What do we have? Two units of Turkish archers, town militia, spear. Ooh, spear militia. Gonna have to watch out for them. Two Turkomans and Arab cavalry. All right, not bad, not bad. We got this. And I'm gonna give it one more go to see if the Crown Prince can give us a speech. Nope. He just doesn't want to do it. I think the Crown Prince just does not want to speech it. That's fine, he doesn't have to. No pressure. No one's pressuring him. All right. See, let's do a quick little setup here. All right, so we have everything set up. This actually looks like an almost identical fight, if not almost, actually identical fight to what was that we took? Was it Adana? Adana was our first fight? Or was it Tbilisi? Was it Tbilisi that was? You know what? I can't remember. It was either Adana or Tbilisi, where we had the archers here on the side, our horse archers here, and we were ramming down the walls. Except this time, I'm not going to have a ram on all sides. I'm just going to take these three up the middle. This guy's going to get that gate. This guy's going to get that wall. This guy's going to get that wall. So we'll go ahead and do that. And we'll get these archers moving right on up here. And our horses. Right over here. Yeah, beautiful. Okay. Actually, get these guys kind of there-ish, firing over that wall. These guys here. Make sure to get their Turkish archers. If you guys could run, that would be fantastic. Yeah, get those Turkish archers down. Ooh, they can't. Yeah, those peasant archers have that short range. What a pity. How are these archers doing? They're taking some decent damage. Good, good. Yeah, our missile troops are doing some good work here. The horses are probably going to do really good because they're facing this way. That's good. That makes me happy. These Turkish archers are a little bit better, but the only thing attacking them are peasant archers, and I don't think they have straight line of fire. Nope, they're lobbing up into the air. Pity. That's a pity. Yeah, they're firing straight up into the air. Are these guys firing kind of forward-ish? Yeah, these guys are firing horizontally. That's nice, that's nice. Good. So these guys are down at 72. That's looking beautiful. None of our rams are on fire yet. That's always a plus. Like the Swiss flag. Turkish archers are taking a little bit of damage here, but they'll be fine, I think. They'll be fine. These guys are down to 52. That's great. That's just great. Yeah, as soon as these... Oh, did they? Yeah, they just opened up the gate. They opened up the gate. Go, run. Get in there. Just get in there. Yeah, everyone just rush right in. Rush right in. You can stay here to get through there. Where's our other unit of Saracens? Oh, these are our Saracens. Nice. Get on over that side. And you guys attack here. And you guys kind of run in here. You as well. Kind of start flanking everything. Those archers should break as soon as we touch them. Yep, there we go. Nice and broken. So we can sort of flank this town militia if we want to. And we'll get you guys. You know what? You guys can just start firing over into here. Oh, they've taken... No, you know what? Let's get them out. They've taken a lot of damage from whatever archers they had. Oh, that's right, because they had two units of Turkomans just sitting on the plaza. Ooh, that's a lot of archer fire I completely neglected to remember. Let's get this. Yeah, this Saracen militia going right up here. You guys going right into that... Arab cavalry. Yes. Is that their general? Come on, zoom in here. Yes, the Arab cavalry is their general. Where is he? Should be on the left side. Ish. No, I don't see him. I don't see the general. So it's always hard to pick out the Muslim faction generals. There he is. Is that him? Is that him? Yeah, that's him. There he is. Yep, that's him right there. Alright, so he's kind of in the middle of that troop. It'll take a while to kill him. But yeah, you guys keep going. You flank there, and you go in here. And you go right in here, and you guys kind of start going... We'll have one unit going here, one unit going here. Yeah. Yeah, you guys get this general unit in the back, but if you could run right up to him, that would be great. Yeah, there you go. There you go. And you guys just go in and attack there. You guys get here. You two kind of go over to that side. We'll use the sending two units over to that side, but still, no matter. Let's get our general. Wherever, there you go. Get our archers in here, actually. Oh, their general unit's down. The general's down. Oh, Captain Mustafa. Crown Prince Mustafa and Captain Mustafa. Look at that. What do you know? It's almost like Mustafa's a pretty common name in this part of the world. Who would have thought? All right. Yeah, now it's really pretty much just a fast forward match from here on out, because there's no strategy left. It's just batter down their horses with spears. So just get everyone kind of going in there. There you go. That's just a waiting game. 82, 83, 84, 85. Good. Killing them nice and quickly. Yeah, horses don't do particularly well against spear units. Kind of a pity for them. And the little archers they have left stand no chance to our infantry might. Oh, still have some two town militia here. And they are dead. Good and dead. 382. That's a lot of losses. Yeah, I really wasn't paying attention to those Turkomans in the plaza just pelting away at my horse archers. That's too bad. 98 casualties taken for this spear militia. Wow, that's a lot of casualties. Oh well, they're spear militia. Who cares about them? So Aleppo falls to us. What we'll probably end up doing is sending a couple of troops east to assist with Edessa. But I don't know. We're gonna have to see about that. Oh, great. Yeah, of course. Yeah, the more towns we take over, the more inevitable it is that we get this stupid... And he's ignorant. Oh, for crying out loud. I need a moment. Well, it looks like we already have an heir to the throne that we're going to have to get killed eventually one of these days. Because it looks like he's going to have one authority when he takes the throne. Only warrior does not give authority. Oh, never mind, never mind. He's got an honorable ruler. Okay, so he's going to have three authority when he takes the throne. That's not bad, I guess. But why? Like, every general just gets ignorant all the time. It's really quite infuriating. No matter, no matter. Keep a positive mental attitude. Gonna have to do that. We'll see what happens when he takes the throne. If he has less than three, we'll kill him off. If not, he should be fine. I mean, our Sultan has had two authority for the last, 12, 13 turns, and he only just got three right now, so we should be okay. We should be okay. All of this can still move quite a significant amount. Should we just blast on south to Acre? Start this war off early with Egypt? Yeah, we'll take all of this, and we'll send it on up here to Edessa. Now, I'm going to wager this entire little group of army. I'm going to go ahead and wager this on our Sultan's three authority. And I'm going to put these guys right here. I'm hoping I don't lose them at the end of this turn or the start of next turn. I'm really hoping I don't, because I kind of want to take Edessa early on and not just have it under siege for, 5-6 turns. I don't want to waste that amount of time. So we'll send those guys over there and we'll start retraining when we get money back, of course, next turn. We'll start retraining up our militia forces that we're sending on over. And then we'll swing down and start our wars with Egypt and take over Damascus and Jerusalem and etc. etc. We're gonna need this getting into a fortress soon. Wow, that's so low. Ooh, this is gonna be a fortress pretty soon. Okay, that's nice. I wonder if we should. Yeah, you know what? That strikes me as a pretty good idea. Let's go ahead and do a nice little switcheroo here. We'll get him in there. And we'll get Tutush down here. So that is going to be growing really nicely. We'll probably get that to a fortress in just around three turns. Yeah, just around three turns, we're going to get that to 4,500. So that'll be nice to kind of have some troops pumping out of here, especially assisting with Iconium against the Byzantines when the inevitable happens. But good. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. I'm glad we switched those guys around. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna risk so many troops right now to our Sultan's three authority. We have so many captains out on the field. Just by statistical odds, we're probably gonna lose one of these armies. But I'm gonna risk it. I'm gonna see what happens here. And oh no, it speaks of loyalty. That's actually not too bad, you know? No, no chivalry, 27, low loyalty, no. Hey, we didn't lose any armies. Did we lose an army back here? Did we just lose an army? Oh, we lost an army! No! That was, who was that? That was the Sipahi. That was the two Sipahi. We just lost two Sipahis? Or was it one? It was two Sipahis. Oh, we just lost some really good troops there. No matter, we're making back, that money and upkeep, so that's fine. This was the important force, really. Those two Sipahis, whatever. I mean, they can't storm castle walls or anything, so that's fine. Get you around here. Get you. There you go. Get there, just in case. Get you up there. Okay, yeah, that looks like a pretty decent force. I think we're going to be able to take Edessa with that. All right, so we're going to want large town. Let's go for two rams and the rest in ladder. Yeah, there we go. All right. Do we want siege towers? What do they have? Oh, that's a lot of archers. No, I don't think we want siege towers. They'll burn pretty quickly. How's their infantry looking? Pretty good too. This might be tough. This might actually be tough. We'll probably leave them under siege for an additional one turn, maybe. Yeah. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do that. Let's get you up to a wooden castle. Yes, let's get you up to a wooden castle. Oh, we have 2,400 for something needed. 2,400. What was it? An archery range, I believe, here, was it? Yes, it... Whoa, practice range. Ooh, and Murad has... Oh, what does he have? What does he have that lowers our... Oh, he has this architect. There you go. 10% discount on construction costs. That's nice. Oh, that works out. Yeah, let's get some Turkish archers going. We don't have any of them on the field, or recruited. We have them on the field, just not recruitable. We are now the most advanced faction. There you go. 100%. Number one, the Turks. Doing pretty good in population, pretty good in decent in military, not very good in financial. Milan, the bastards with the banks. Oh, well. How much are we making per turn now? Just about a little over 3,500. That's not, or 3,600. Yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad. It actually helps that we lost cavalry units. Anyway, let's see if I need some agent movements, and if not, we end the turn. Oh, so they already have, they have Moscow already. All right. Can we get some profit here? Yes, we can. All right, so they got Riga, Novgorod, and Moscow. Oh, they have Helsinki too? No, they don't have Helsinki. What does it look like on a map? Oh, no, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. All right, let's get you going over to talk to Poland, which they'll probably have... I think Krakow's over here, somewhere like that. Or, I don't know. We'll run into them. We'll run into them. Yeah, I think we're good to end the turn right now. Yeah. All right, another candidate for adoption, this time with mixed loyalties. Even worse than speaks of loyalty. But he has 2 points in chivalry. Oh, that's so horrible. I wonder why they always have this. Can we not just get a husband or a candidate for adoption or something that actually really, really, really wants to be in the family and loves us? Baghdad got a land clearance. Yeah, we're going to have to up that as quickly as possible. What would give us more growth? I'm going to bet on the farming for now, I think. Yeah, let's keep getting that farming up. I don't know if we'll get irrigation, but let's get that and then the 2400 one, which is... What's it called? Crop rotation. Okay, we'll get up to crop rotation and then we'll start going for the town hall for the extra growth percentage with the health. And no, I don't think mosques give... Do they? No, mosques don't give growth percentage like cathedrals do. That's a pity. I'd forgotten about that. So you can only grow through farming and the town halls. No, that's a pity. Oh well. Okay, so yeah, upgrade farming, upgrade the town halls, grow. Get on up there. Ooh, we can give you... Ooh. What do we do first? Let's actually look at Yerevan first. You know what? We'll do that, and we'll do that. There we go. Get some growth going all here on our eastern borders. And I believe I said I would leave you under siege for one more turn. Yeah, I think I said that. I'm going to stick by it because they have a lot of archers. And I don't really want to lose too many troops for the time being. I really want to start assisting in this little war of mine that I'm going to start very soon with the Egyptians. Any more movement here from agents? Ragusa should be coming into view. It's like, it's literally like right here in this like little fog of war right there. It's, yeah, it should be right here or here. But in one of these areas is a town and we're going to be able to speak to the Venetians. Do good work there and end the turn. Oh, we have an Egyptian boat here I didn't look at. I wonder if they have an army there. Ooh, is Egypt gonna landfall on us? Suitable husband. Ooh. Oh, ask and ye shall receive, apparently. I don't know which of the gods we're talking to, but... Yeah, 16, good chivalry, loyalty beyond question. You know what? Nefis ad-Dawla got a pretty good husband here. That's... really nice. And a crusade has been called on Cairo at turn 18. That's the earliest I've ever seen it. Wow.
It is Christendom itself that is threatened. And it is every Christian's duty to defend all that is holy. His Holiness the Pope has called a crusade to reclaim the Holy Lands from the infidel, who would deny Christian pilgrims their right to visit the holy places. It is time for the armies of Christendom to put aside their differences and unite under one banner, the sign of the cross, and give back God's children what is rightfully theirs, or die trying.
That seems like a noble effort. I mean, nothing bad has ever happened under the sign of the cross, so, you know, that seems like a worthy venture. Yeah, I think they got something there. Right, let's get these two guys out. Build up some communal farming here. Get you growing. Get you growing as well. One turn for a potential point in chivalry. What do you have? Come on, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Where's that rule? Oh, honorable ruler. 4 chivalry, 2 authority. I don't know if a small masjid can trigger the fifth one. The saintly ruler, or whatever it's called. I don't know if the rank 1 mosque can trigger that. No, you know what? I'm going to leave that right there for someone else. Like, for instance, once we get the crown prince out of here, we could probably move Tutush over and get him a second point guaranteed. Yeah, that strikes me as a pretty good idea. So we're going to leave that small masjid there. And we're going to retrain you. And we'll get... You know what? Since we're probably going to move him out in the next turn, we'll get some dirt roads just to kind of assist on our movement through here. Ooh, kind of wish I had roads in Antioch. No matter. No matter. Ooh, we're going to have to take Edessa this turn. That's right. You should have gotten... Yeah, you're now at stone walls, so we'll get... Another spear militia here, just in case. Just in case. Kitbuga of Yazd has 4 chivalry. Is our sultan going to die anytime soon? No, he's 48. He's actually pretty damn good. So we'll get Kitbuga of Yazd heading over to Adana. And we'll actually get Tutush heading over to Aleppo. Because as soon as we get... Mustafa out of here. Next turn, we'll be able to move him in and start building on that mosque to get him another point of chivalry. So that works there. Oh, poor Tutush. He felt unappreciated because we just had him stuck in Adana. Selfish prick. Yeah, I'm just sitting here in a castle. Yeah. Like, oh, well, he is swift to judge, right? That's probably why, why he feels unappreciated so quickly. Come on, man, you're only 20. Give us a break. We've got things going on here. So yeah, Kitbuga has married Nefis, or Nefise. Don't know how that would be pronounced. Got spear militia in Antioch. Got a nice wooden castle upgraded. Was that Aleppo? I think so. Ooh, Caesarea's ready to upgrade. Right on time. Believe this was turn number 3, I said? I don't know, 2, 3, who knows. But we'll be able to upgrade that. Ooh, will we? No, we won't be able to upgrade it. Oh, we're going to need to wait a little bit because we're not going to have the money. I wonder if we sack Edessa, which is probably not the best idea in the world. How much money would we get from that? There's really only one way to find out, right? Yeah, there's only one way to find out how much money we would get from sacking Edessa. All right, Captain Selim. Okay, so that wasn't a fourth group of archers. I don't know if that is a good or a bad thing. So they only have 3 units of archers, 4 of spears, but 1's town, which is pretty crap. These 3 spear militia are going to cause a lot of trouble, though. I think we have the infantry. Yeah, and we've got our trusty Afghan javelinmen. Oh, we have 2 now. Oh, we've got this. You guys are screwed. Ooh. Come on, come on. 4th time's a charm, Crown Prince. Please, give us a speech. Nope. He's just incapable. No, he doesn't want... Okay, so apparently this one character's bugged. Because I have played as the Turks before, and they have given speeches in the past. I guess the Crown Prince just doesn't want to. He couldn't get off his high horse and come down to earth, come down to reality for 2 seconds to give his men a speech. Nope, just doesn't want to do it. Alright, here we have it, a nice little setup. We're basically just going to blitz right into the front gate, going to take both rams there at the same time, and just Yeah, get right on their walls as quickly as possible. I think we're going to take a lot of losses, but we have just the raw numbers. We have the manpower to do this, or we should at least, provided I don't completely, you know, fuck everything up. And all of you are running? Let's go. Let's go. Let's get our archers up here. Let's get our cavalry over here firing into these guys as well and kind of helping out a bit. They're going to take so much damage. And let's get you guys kind of walking up there. Let's get these Afghans kind of staying right around here. Not running. You guys are running. Yeah, you guys are running a bit. Just fire into whatever you can. Whatever you can damage, even remotely, would help. You as well. You firing? Yeah, you're firing. You're firing. Everyone's firing. All our missiles are firing. I'm going to have to kind of babysit these guys, make sure they don't run to another ladder. Because, you know, that's a thing. Okay, make sure nobody runs over to this side. No, you're staying over here. Go up the left ladders. Go up the... Do not... Good. Okay, good. Good. Wow, they're not doing it. Oh, that's fantastic. I think that's, like, the first time I haven't had to babysit ladder groups. Wow. New things happen every day. This is so great. So great. Okay. Did they get the ram there and it's not on fire? Can you push it in, please? Thank you. Much appreciated. About time. All right. So they're going up there. They're going up there. Everything has come over here. They have Turkomans. Let's get our general kind of over here getting ready to slam into there. Afghans are coming in. Gonna have to make sure our spear troops get in there first. What? Why are...
Four fights with horns made of clay. We are winning the battle.
Why do you do this? Why do you do this, game? Why do you do this? Oh, because they're... Like, just rush in. We'll push them off the side, you know? Haven't you ever, like, played Mountain Blade? Okay, that gate is at 47%. Our Afghans are basically drawing the arrows from everyone because they're down from 120 to 79 and 91. We're just wasting these troops. They're just getting completely wrecked. Completely wrecked. That's actually, you know what? They're aiming at them so much, I kind of feel like I should be pulling them out. Thank you. You've done a wonderful job just drawing the fire off everything. That's marvelous. Marvelous.
Our men have done well.
Oh, wow. Poor Afghans. They're just there as kind of like the... Shoot me! Shoot me! No? It looked like they were rushing out. I guess not. Okay. Let go of the ram, please. Let go of the ram as soon as you... Oh, these guys broke. That's not good. That is not good. That's not good. These guys broke too. Wow. All our units are just breaking. These town militia are gonna die soon at least. That's a plus. Okay, that spear militia is at 136. Oh man. Oh, but yeah, this is definitely not looking good. This looks like it's gonna be a repeat of that horrible town militia step here. Well, we can't really commit our general because there's a lot of spear militia there. The general's definitely gonna die. I wonder if we can... No, we have these guys. You know what? Just try as hard as you can to fire into these Turkish archers. Try as hard as you can. I don't know if you were targeting them already or not, but just try to go for it. We're losing a lot of infantry. We're losing so much infantry. So much. How did these guys break at 84? Huh. Look at that. How do we counter this? What do we do here? Okay. What do we do here? I could try to push through with a unit and flank. Yeah, I'll try who is kind of not on the front lines. Let's get these guys. Oh, you know what? That town militia is still at 15 and not broken. Oh boy. This is... They don't have a general. They just have a regular captain. How do we have town militia at 15? Oh, there we go. 12. The magic number was 12. Okay. Well, we're going to get you over here fighting these Turkish archers, I think. Actually, no. We have all our archers firing into them. So we'll actually have you kind of go here. Oh, that spear militia just broke. You know what? If we can get them kind of behind these Turcomans, that would be great. We have this spear militia who just regrouped. Oh, well, we just killed their captain. Not much good that's going to do, because, I mean, it was still a captain. Maybe they'll break a little bit. Let's get the spear militia just kind of rushing in here. Yeah. See if we can do something with them. Okay, those Saracens made the Turcomans break. Just try to mop up. Try to capture as much as you can as it runs back. Actually, yeah, let's get them up into this spear militia. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Just try to clean them up, capture as many as you can. And run while you're at it. Please, please run. I'm telling you to run. You're really just walking right now. Thank you. There you go. Just capture as many of them as you can. Come up here and just kind of try to just, like, clean this little area so we can perform a nice proper flank. Let's get you guys, you know what? Yeah, you guys kind of, no, the walls are actually clear on this side. Let's get this Saracen militia, or spear militia down to kind of assist with capturing whatever's there. Okay, they're doing a pretty good job attacking those Turkish archers now. Nice, nice, nice. And then soon, hopefully they'll break soon. Yeah, they just broke. All right. Let's get them attacking those Turcomans. Let's keep just breaking and capturing. Turn them around and kind of clear all this up. 19 Arab cavalry down to 14, 11, 7. Oh yeah, that's good. That's a good job. Okay, no, keep coming back. Keep coming back. Get all the stuff that's broken. Get all the stuff that's broken. Yeah, yeah, there we go. Okay. Oh. I thought I had lost this city for a second there. I mean, again, like I said before, we have the manpower. It's just, we were always going to take so many losses. They just have way too much stuff. Way too much. Too much spear militia, too many archers. But it looks like we're managing to turn this around, finally. Come on, get into group one. There you go. Yeah, get those Turkish archers down. You know what? They have so little left. Just storm. Storm, storm, storm. Oh, yeah. Sorry. That order made you break. I'm sorry. Oops. Oopsie daisy. Let's actually get our archers over here. Let's get our cab over here, too. Firing into this spear militia, if they would be so kind. Let's get our Afghans kind of... Where would this spear militia come down if they decide to come down? Actually, let's get our Afghans kind of running up here. We'll get this group kind of firing. No, you don't want to. There you go. There, and there. Okay, perfect. Great. Let's get you guys up there. Just get killing. There's so little left here on the plaza. Just kill it all. You have a lot of infantry on there. These guys are shaken and just running into my Afghans. I'm assuming, you know what? They're wavering. Our Afghans have really good stats. They're probably going to be able to kill them on the ground, not on the walls. So they'll waver until they're broken. Our Afghans are not going to take very many more losses. And they'll be able to break that spear militia. There you go. Break that spear militia and take it. Do I bother giving anyone any more XP? No, just end it now. Oh, that's so many people lost. I feel like I'm performing so poorly on these initial city takes. But, you know, we don't have siege equipment, we don't have ballistas, we don't have catapults, we don't have heavy infantry, we don't have too many archers, or not good ones at least. Once we get a lot more Turkish archers or Ottoman infantry, we should be steamrolling all these cities. And, you know, dismounted Sepahi Lancers, a lot more Saracen militia, some heavy Janissary infantry. You know, we are dealing with some very subpar troops right now. So, I'm not doing as well as I would like, but we're doing okay. We're doing okay.
Allah has granted us victory!
Yes, he has, and we would only be able to sack that for 1685. Which would put us over the edge to turning Khazaria into a fortress. Yes. Yes, it would. I believe so. Yep, 7200. So we'll be able to upgrade that into a fortress next turn. And start pumping out some Turkish archers. Or no, the Turkish archers are coming right now, right? Yeah. Okay. Oh, that's right. Dismounted Sepahi Lancers. That's what I'm waiting for. To get some nice, solid spear infantry coming down to Iconium. Get them some Saracen militia once we upgrade this to a city watch, which we can do right now. But I'd really rather upgrade this to a fortress next turn, so I'm gonna hold off on that. Actually, you know what? With the capture of Edessa, it looks like I can actually do both things. Yes, I can. I'm going to have money next turn to upgrade Khazaria regardless. Okay, so we're going to be able to get a town watch here, or sorry, city watch here. Get some Saracen militia going in four turns to aid on our war with the Byzantines in a little bit. And we're going to be able to get Turkish archers and dismounted Sepahi lancers. Things are looking good for the early Ottoman Empire. Osman would be proud. But I believe that is all we can do right now. Oh, nope, never mind. There we go. Ragusa. Let's see if they would be willing to give us all of this. Beautiful. Making just tiny little amounts of money more. Trade rights really is like nothing. You get just, you know, you don't get like 300-400 more per turn. You get maybe like 30, 40, some pitiful number like that. It's really not that much, but you know, every bit helps. If they agree to it, why not, right? Let's see. Okay, so this is still all... Yeah, Riazan is still rebel, so is Sarkel. Okay, that's still all rebel, so we're still in the clear from having anything attack Tbilisi anytime soon. Get that growing nicely, Salim. You're doing a great job there. Are there any, okay, we could probably get... Yeah, we actually should have, you know, invested in that masjid quite a while ago. This number would probably be up to about 3,500 by now if we had done that. So that's a pity that we've been spending so much time doing that. We're not going to be able to do it next turn either because of Khazaria, but we'll definitely be able to do it the turn after. Alright, I believe that's all we can do. Let's actually see what troops we can start moving back west from Edessa. Alright, Edessa, we can drop you down to low. We're still getting enough to get that fortress next turn. And yeah, you know what? I think we might actually risk moving all of this down. I think that would be a good idea. Yeah. I'm gonna risk it. If we lose them, so be it. We'll just have to train up more troops. But you have way too much chivalry to move you out. I think we're gonna leave you in Aleppo. We will not lose them. Just keep a good attitude and we will not lose them to our Sultan's abysmal authority. Ooh, 29 loyal, no. Well, two chivalry, but he's 29. No. We're not gonna adopt him. Did we lose anyone? No, we didn't. Oh, beautiful. We still have them. Great. Absolutely great. Okay, good. I like that. So let's go ahead and get them moving down to start taking over Acre. Is Acre still relatively undefended? Yes, it is. So is Jerusalem. I wonder if the Egyptians are pulling back to defend their the crusade against them. That would actually benefit me quite a lot. Quite a lot. Really, really benefit me. But yeah, let's not spend any more money because we have something to do here, and that's upgrade this to a fortress. So we have 494 left. Not going to be room for very much. But it is going to be room for another Saracen militia here. Excellent. Excellent. That is actually looking very good. Let's get you guys as far as you can go. Let's get these guys over there. Let's get you into Aleppo. Sorry, we're going to have to wait to get that small masjid next turn, Tutush. So let's get... you know what? How are we looking on horse archers here? We have three units of Sepahis, so you can... spare us the upkeep, because I really want to get as rid of all my Turcomans as quickly as possible. They're such bad units. I really just don't like them. Did we have you going in there or to Adana? You know what? I'm very confused right now. Who is going where? Well, I don't want to waste turns, so we'll have Murad go down to Adana. They both have the same chivalry, so that is okay. That is fine. We're not losing anything anywhere. We will get these four units of spears in there. Okay. 4,600 a turn. That should be good for this masjid next turn. This masjid next turn. Yeah, and a little bit left over for some recruitment if need be. Okay, I think we really have nothing left we can do except end the turn, I believe. Oh no, we still have some movement. We'll get you going to... let's do kind of... Yeah, let's not bother with the Holy Roman Empire. I'm pretty sure this diplomat will be able to take care of that as he swings through, gets Poland and Denmark as well, and we'll just have you do the Italian peninsula. Hopefully just drop down to Naples, get Sicily's trade, then go up, get Milan, the Papal States, head over to France, Portugal here. They should still have Pamplona, Spain, the Moors. Yeah, we'll get you doing that. So just go this way. Oh, actually, yeah, the Holy Roman Empire would be on the way, because I forget they have Bologna. That's right. All right. Good, good, good. This is looking great. We are looking pretty good so far. I'd really like to get Trebizond and a couple of watchtowers here, just make sure there's nothing kind of storming through my northern areas. But that will have to wait, unfortunately, because we do have a lot going on here in the south. So that's where all our finances are getting held up for the moment. Anyway. Oh, the Byzantines have an Orthodox priest in Iconium. I'm going to have to get an imam over there, kind of keep my Islam at a decent level. Gonna have to kill them soon, get all their stupid Orthodox priests out of the way. Ooh, that's a big army of Russians heading on over there. I'm glad I saw that. I'm gonna have to really focus on getting Tbilisi up. Oh, we've got a brave guy. That's actually... I might take that? I really just like that one plus one morale. I might actually accept that just because. I know, accepting all these candidates for adoption really has a lot of chances of, you know, making our generals incredibly ignorant. But, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. It's another general. Murad feels less appreciated. So he's losing loyalty. Murad... I can't remember who Murad is on the family tree. Murad is Crown Prince Mustafa's... Oh, that's right. He was the first guy we adopted. So he would have every right to feel unappreciated because we just adopted another one. And Crown Prince Mustafa sadly does not have any natural born sons. They're all daughters. So it doesn't look like he's going to be continuing the line anytime soon, except this game doesn't actually follow any kind of logic whatsoever when giving the heir apparent title to someone. It literally just throws it around all over the place. I've never seen any kind of lineage that makes any kind of sense whatsoever. It's been given to completely random people at random times. That is one of the downfalls of this game, sadly. I wish it was kind of like Rome's system where you could change it on your own. So yeah, Acre should fall relatively easy to us. I think what we'll probably do here with Antioch, next turn we'll start building this Ballista Maker, because I really want to get some siege equipment that's able to take down gates at range as quickly as possible. I don't like doing castle sieges or city sieges with ladders and rams. I keep losing a lot of troops that way. They can't make it down there, can they? No, they can't make it anywhere near there. We're going to need roads after we build a ballista maker. So much to do! Alright, small masjid for you. Did you just lose a point of chivalry? Oh, what did you get? What did you get? Or... I could have sworn he had a point. Am I just going crazy? Is that what's going on? Am I going crazy? Lax justice. Is it this? Did he just get lax justice? I'm going to have to check. I could have sworn he had one point in chivalry. That is so annoying. This is a horrible general. Should have just killed him at birth. All right, Baghdad, what do you need? You could use some growth, but we'll get... that's only 600 and it's two turns. We'll get that town hall first. But we promised Selim he would have his second masjid. I think we're going to need to get Tbilisi up to at least fortress before we focus on Yerevan. So we'll do that. Edessa could use some masjid, get that other point of chivalry. You're going to be going, ooh, I just noticed that the Crown Prince is kind of doing all our taking over. He did the crusade on Adana, then he took Antioch, then he took Aleppo, now he's heading down to Acre. Got some decent command there, got some very nice stats. 9 piety, ooh. Oh, you know what? Oh, it's turned 20. I am so dumb. I have not looked at when I could declare jihad. I could probably have done it a turn or two ago. Ah, that is so annoying. I have not been paying attention to that. But, yeah, you know what? I think we'll leave this episode off here. I'm going to have to take a think into where we want to jihad and what my next moves want to be in this series. So, yeah, we'll leave it off here. We'll take a little break. I'll think on that. And so, you know, as far as that goes, thank you everyone for watching. And join me back in episode 4.